Hello, and thank you for joining us today. This video is part of Orchestra of the Swan's Musical Share series, where we bring a selection of our favourite melodies directly to you. These videos have been carefully developed to spark conversation and prompt memories. But above all else, we simply hope that you'll enjoy this time together. If you would like more information about our players and their choice of music, then please follow the link to Orchestra of the Swan's website, where you can download our supporting document called Sound Bites. This document also includes song sheets with lyrics for pieces in the video you might like to sing along to. Singing along is a great way to join in with the musicians in this film. You could also clap your hands, tap your feet, shake a tambourine, or use any percussion instruments you have to hand. If you'd prefer a quieter way to join in, you could simply move along with our music from where you sit, or try waving a scarf or foam roller in time to the music. The film you're about to watch is called Post-War Pops and features our musicians Sal, Ollie, and myself, Di. We will be playing music by Eva Cassidy, The Beatles, and ABBA, so get comfortable and enjoy our musical shares.
Remember that Spike Milligan drawing about a baby sardine seeing its first submarine? That's what it was like on the tube on the way here. A load of hot, angry people with their faces in a stranger's armpit. Nobody with enough room to take their coats off. The ones with seats doing that special glazed look so they can pretend they haven't seen anyone pregnant or old or with a broken leg. I can't wait to get out of London for a few days. I just need to throw a few clothes in the bag, feed the cat, and then I'm off to Euston to catch the train. The party at Pete's starts at 8. Hello, dear diary. I'm a bit plastered, so my writing is probably all squiffy, but I need to write down that I met a girl tonight, and she's beautiful, and her name's Lucy, and I need to see her again. I'm so happy and so drunk. Thank you. Haven't written anything for a few days because it's been a crazy whirl. Pete got me Lucy's number and we've been on 3 dates already. Had a small bust up earlier though because she asked me what was my favourite Beatles song. Hers is Imagine. I said that isn't really even the Beatles, just John Lennon, and doesn't she find his voice a bit nasal compared to Paul McCartney? Turns out she doesn't like being challenged. First fly in the ointment. A nice night in on the sofa. My parents are away, so we've had the house to ourselves. Watched Jeeves and Wooster and sunk a couple of good bottles of wine with a Chinese takeaway. Things are getting pretty serious. We were pottering around town and walked past the jewellers, and Lucy picked out an antique sapphire in the window and said, "There, that's the one. Why wait when you know the girl is right?" I won't lie, I was absolutely terrified for a second. I just smiled and mumbled something. But I've been thinking and thinking and, you know, I can imagine talking to her all my life. And she's the best friend I've ever had. So what more do you need? She dumped me. I can't believe it. I'm not going to try and explain it here because I can't. I'm going to bed. Good night. Thank you. Dear Diary, woke up feeling terrible and was still lying in bed at 10:30 when the doorbell rang. Well, I went down and there was Lucy. Can I come in? Suppose so. Then once we're in the hall and the door is shut, she starts kissing me and the waterworks are turned on and she says she's had the worst sleepless night ever and please will I give it another go. I didn't even pretend to play it cool. Yes, yes, Lucy, of course. What the hell else do I want to do with my life except be with you? Thank heaven for second chances.
Thank you for joining us today, and we look forward to seeing you again on one of our next videos.